So thank you, Thomas. Congratulations. In few words, the stage, the l'échappé.
In a few words.
Difficult.
It was a hard start, but I like to do starts like this because I'm almost always in the breakaway when it's a start like this. And today was normally a chance for the sprinters or the strong sprinters, but there are only three sprinters here or four sprinters. So today was a big chance, and we just went full the whole day. And in the finish, it was very nice for me.
Donc une journée qui est partie très vite, échappée difficile au départ de l'étape, mais c'est ce qui lui plaît, il aime bien partir très vite. C'était une étape promise aux sprinters, mais il y a relativement peu de sprinters dans le peloton, 3, 4, et donc l'occasion était belle de tenter d'échapper, et ils ont travaillé dur pour aller au bout, et ça a marché, donc bravo. Questions to Thomas De Gendt.
Take it with me, please.
Yes. Thomas, how important is having a victory in the breakaway?
I wanted to have a victory here in Tour de Romandie because I didn't win here yet. So I want to have a stage victory in at least every World Tour race that I start. So now I have one in Romandie, and also it's important for the team to ride aggressive and to try to win. Also as an example to the young riders we have here. Yesterday Remy Metz was in the break and he tried to win. And today it was my turn, so it's important for me and but also for the team that we win here.
Donc Thomas De Gendt dit, un de ses objectifs c'est de gagner une étape dans les courses par étape World Tour qu'il dispute. Il n'en avait pas encore gagné ici au Tour de Romandie, donc il tenait à le faire. Il évoque aussi l'exemple pour les jeunes. Il dit les jeunes qui ont tenté d'échapper hier, qui ont échoué, c'est aussi une manière de leur montrer qu'on peut aller au bout, qu'il faut avoir du courage. Demonstration, de faire un peu la leçon aux petits jeunes, de montrer qu'on peut y arriver. Et c'est important pour l'équipe aussi, bien sûr, de gagner, de se montrer et de réussir ce coup.
Okay.
First of all, congratulations for the performance and for the victory. We can say that it is a victory as the game style, finally. It's not a game style. The tomorrow stage has been very, very difficult. If you think that this situation was a good deal for you, because the peloton was scary.
Okay.
I don't think they were scared. The GC guys will go full tomorrow anyway. Today was for the sprinters, so the guys who need to chase, they will go easy tomorrow anyway. They gave us 3 minutes, but then we took 4 or 5 minutes extra because we were still going full. And I heard they were chasing with a few teams, but we just kept going really full until the first intermediate sprint. So they didn't give us almost 8 minutes. We took them.
Donc Thomas De Gendt dit c'est parce que la question était le compte la montre en course de demain peut-être effrayer les coureurs et c'est pour ça que l'échappé a pris à son terme. Thomas De Gendt réfute l'hypothèse et dit non, personne n'a peur du contre-la-montre de demain, tout le monde a roulé fort et le peloton a laissé 2-3 minutes à l'échappée. Les autres minutes, c'est l'échappée qu'ils ont pris parce qu'elle allait à fond jusqu'au premier sprint intermédiaire, vraiment à fond. Donc c'est eux qui ont amélioré leur avance, c'est pas le peloton qui leur a laissé de l'avance. Et tout le monde a roulé derrière, il n'y a que les coureurs du classement général vont jouer le contre-la-montre à fond demain, c'est pas aujourd'hui que ça s'est joué pour eux. Other questions for Francis?
Victor Karpmetz was in the break with you yesterday for the small break and then again today. How important is he as a teammate and what advantage did he give you today?
Yeah, well, he brings the time trial, the know-how for the time trial in the team. And if I have a question before the time trial, I can ask him. And we were talking about the time trial of tomorrow, 2 weeks ago, and he gave me the profile of the time trial. And he said, but the day before there is a uphill start and I want to go full on the climb to get the legs turning already and to know the feeling on the same feeling 25 minutes up low. And I said, okay, I will join you and we will go just full the whole day. So we made a plan 2 weeks ago and we were hyping each other up yesterday already to go from kilometer zero. And we even have a WhatsApp group with also Louis Vervaak, but he didn't go in the break with us. So yeah, it was a plan already 2 weeks ago, and today he gave his all for me. He went a block until he was really finished. So today he was really important for me, but for the team he is important for the time trials also. We can all ask him questions about anything, about aerodynamics, and he will answer them with a lot of passion.
Donc, l'échappée du jour s'est décidée de façon préméditée. L'autre soudain avait deux coureurs à l'avant. Le coéquipier de Thomas De Gendt avait dit qu'il voulait tenter dans la première montée une espèce de répétition en contre-la-montre de main, donc jouer à fond les 25 premières minutes de la première ascension. Il a informé de cet objectif Thomas De Gendt qui a dit alors moi je vais te rejoindre et on va partir comme ça et on ira après à fond. Le coéquipier après s'est laissé glisser, puis Thomas a continué à fond. Donc c'était une stratégie décidée il y a 2 semaines qui est allée à son terme. Et ça, c'est une belle satisfaction pour eux. Other questions, autre question? Oui.
Yeah, Thomas, did you think at some point of the race that you could get a yellow jersey?
Alors, est-ce que Thomas De Gendt a pensé au maillot jaune pendant un certain moment de l'étape? Did you think to the yellow jersey at one moment in the
Because you were pushing hard till the end, you know?
No, but Nathan Brown was the best in the GC. I don't know at how many seconds. But I was at more than 3 minutes, so I was just wanted to finish the race. I could go slower than the final kilometers, but I just wanted to finish and stop the race. So I just kept going my speed that I was pushing for the last 170 kilometers, and yeah, just wanted to finish. If it was possible for the yellow jersey, then I would have tried my best, but. More than 3 minutes. It would be difficult. As still, Nathan Brown was not so far behind. I don't know what place he finished, but yellow jersey was, I think, almost impossible today.
Donc le maillot jaune était presque impossible aujourd'hui. Nathan Brown était mieux placé que le général que Thomas De Gendt. Donc il a roulé pas pour le maillot jaune, mais pour être sûr d'aller au bout de l'échappée pour faire sa course et ne pas interrompre son effort. That's all. Thank you, Thomas.